Pow! Wow, that was a weird sound effect. Hello everybody, welcome to this episode where we're going to discuss about how to make a bullet fire, simple as that. So this is a basic prototype, so I just imported a standard asset, FPS controller, and what I just did, I created a little barrel for it. A tiny little barrel. Just enough so that way you can see on the camera. And in addition to that, I created a bullet spawn, which is where the bullet will come out from. So it's not going to actually come out in real life from the back of the gun out. It's going to spawn in out here. And I also created a small bullet, which is just a sphere, and it's just colored yellow. That's it. Now let me show you some programming on how to get the firing mechanic to work and to make the bullets disappear. So what I have attached to the player, the standard asset player, I have a public variable, bullet prefab, which will store my yellow ball there. And I have the bullet speed to tell me how fast it should go. In the beginning, I would look for the bullet spawn, so that way I know where to spawn it. And in the update, I get the player's input. So in this case, I use the method get button down fire one. In this case, I can just press the first mouse button. And inside of that if statement, if the player presses the button, make a temporary bullet of that prefab. And the reason why is because you don't want to actually use the actual prefab and then accidentally destroy it. So get the temporary bullet, get the rigid body of that temporary bullet, and just set it so that way it shoots off in the direction that you're looking at the speed of what you have it set to. In this case, I have it set to 10, kind of slow, but just find it nice and I can see it. So back to here, before I move on to the bullet more, I just want to show you like what I have for the bullet. So the bullet has a rigid body and a script attached, another script attached to it called bullet script. And that's the next script I'm going to show you right now. So in the bullet script, I only have this, like, what I guess you would call a paragraph of code. And I just have a special function called OnCollisionEnter. And what it does is that if it touches anything that has a collider, run this piece of function here. Run this code. So if the bullet touches anything, we want to destroy it, no matter what. But if it touches the target, I want to destroy it. And you can do the same thing for if you just, you know, touched a enemy, destroy this bullet, and maybe reduce the enemy's health down. So back to here, to do a little more rundown, I have the targets set to have a tag target, which matches with what the script says in the OnCollisionEnter. So if this bullet, if it hits a game object that has a target, then destroy it. So there you go. So this is just a method on how to get the firing mechanic to work. There are multiple different ways to do things. So my code is not the right way. So there's another method called raycasting, which I will do next. Thank you everybody for watching. Hope this helped out. Comment down below if you have any questions. Subscribe if you want to see more of this. And in the next video, I may show how to do it differently. And I'll see you in the next episode. Bye.